So we are back, and today we want to talk about B plus trees. I encourage you to watch the previous video in the channel and in this playlist, and also watch this B trees and B plus trees video by Abdul Bari before we continue. To visualize a sample B plus tree, we will use this visualizer. This visualizer is made by University of San Francisco, and you can use the link in the URL, and I will paste it also in the description. The B plus tree that I'm going to make will be of degree 4, which means each node can have 4 children and maximum 3 keys. If we have nothing in our tree, like right now there are no nodes in our tree, it's empty canvas as you can see. The first node that will be created would be the root node, and it will also be type of leaf. So let's say we add number 10. A new node is created. Key 10 is added to this node, and this is a leaf node and also the root node. Well, we cannot necessarily say it's leaf because we don't have a tree yet. It's just a single node, but eventually we will consider this as a leaf node, and you will see why. When we want to add a new key, we will have to find the path to the node that should store that key. For now, we only have a single node, so it would be easy. It's our root, and the key should be inserted in the same node. We can insert one more key, and it will be added to the same node, because each node can have up to 3 keys. We are degree of 4. So next we want to add key 40. And obviously this node is full. We cannot add it here. So we should create a new node and add 40 here. What we will also do is to find the mid element in this node, which is 20. And anything after the mid would be also added in the new leaf node. So this new leaf node should have 30 and 40. Let's see if that works. So as you can see, the new leaf node is created. The previous leaf node has splitted, so 30 has came to this new leaf node. And since now we have 2 leaf nodes, we need to create a root because we want to keep the tree as balanced. So the key that we chose for the root was the first key in the new leaf node. So if you remember B-trees or B+Trees rules, the left child of a node or of a key should store all the keys smaller than parent key. So right now we have 10 and 20 here, which both are smaller than 30, and the right one can have equal or greater than parent key. So we have 30 here and 40. So what should happen when we want to add 100? Again, this node is full. So what we have to do is to create a new node, and like before, we have to split this current node, move 90 here, so this new node would have 90, and the new key should come also here. So this will be our new leaf node, and also we make sure that this node points to this node, like here and here and here. So we created the new leaf here, but what happens to the parent? Because the parent is also full right now, and this tree right here is not following B+Tree or B3 rules. So we also need to split this node, and let's say we don't have this event here. We need to create a new node, and this new node should point to these two leaves. So now which number should be the value of the key in this new internal node. Again, to follow B3 rules, anything in this node should be less than the number here, and anything in this node can be greater or equal to the number that is the key in this new internal node. So that number would be 90. So as we create new internal nodes, we can pass this 70 to parent node. And since we don't have a parent, we create it, and that would be a root. So this 70 has two childs. One is this node with 30 and 50, and the other one is this node with single key with number 90, and the rest of the tree is also balanced. So let me clear all of these and add 100. Let's see what happens. I reduced the animation a bit here and add 100. So first it finds the node that should store 100. It's this leaf node, and then it splitted this node, added it to the parent, splitted the parent, and 70 goes up, 90 comes here, and the tree is balanced again. Now the algorithm would be the same even if we add numbers that are not in respective orders. So let's say we add 55 and 56. As you can see, 55 came here, we add 56. So this leaf node now has three keys and four children. And let's also try 57 and 58. Again, we should see that this internal node will break. 56 should go to the root, and there should be two internal nodes here. Note that this algorithm works recursively, so everything that we have said so far should be applied as we go to higher heights. Something that is missing in this visualizer is that all of these keys in the leaf nodes should have a pointer. The pointer should point to the location where the data of key 56 is stored on disk. And this is where we previously called as DB file. In this episode, we have focused on B+Tree insertion and deletion would be topic of next episode. But now that we have understood insertion, finding a key should be very easy for us. To find an element or a key in B+Tree, we should follow the path to the leaf node that should have possibly stored the key. And when we find the leaf node, if the key is inside the leaf node, then we found the key. Now, before we dive into the code example that I have written so far for the database that I'm implementing, we should remember a few things. First thing to remember is that we haven't discussed the structure of a node, how it's represented, and any sort of these operations yet. And these are not the topic of today's video. Second, you may spot abstract implementations of nodes and generic values. And that is because we can store more than just numbers as keys in B+Tree and more than just pointers as values. The first method that we will see is this static getPathToResponsibleNode method. And it gets a list of abstract nodes and tries to fill this list. It accepts a root node for the beginning, the identifier or the key that we are looking for, and the degree of the tree. Also, this method is called recursively to find this path. Therefore, in the beginning, it may be called with the root node, but afterwards, it will follow the path to the leaf node. Also, the way that this path is filled is that the leaf node will be the first node, then any internal nodes would be next, and it will go on until it hits the root node. And obviously, if this node is root and it's also leaf, then we just add that to the path and the list will have only one element. As I said, the code is recursive, so the moment we see a node that its type is leaf, we add it to the beginning of the path and return. Otherwise, we grab all of the children of a node and we loop over them. So here we assume that if we have a node with three keys and there are four children, each child pointer object of a key has a left and right. So for this key, this is the left, this is the right. And for this key, this is the left, this is the right, and goes on. Therefore, if we hit a key that is smaller than the identifier or the key that we are looking for, we choose the left path of that key. And if we hit the last key and the identifier is still larger than the current key, then we go for the right. And again, this is done recursively till we finally hit a leaf node. Now coming to this addIndex method, we need to know which node is the root, the identifier that we want to add, or the key that we want to add, and the value. Again, these are generic. So first thing we do is we create a new path. It's empty. We call the method we just discussed, pass the path, root, the identifier, and the degree. And this method will fill this path for us. Here we store some variables that we will later need in our logic. And the first one, ID for parent to a store, is identifier or a key that we may later want to pass to the parent to a store. So in the example that we had earlier, number 70 was one of the keys that we passed from an internal node to the newly created root node. And we want to store those keys somewhere as we are looping. The second variable, new child for parent, is a newly created node. It could be a leaf or it could be an internal node which has just been created and our parent needs to point to it. And the last variable is called answer. So if you look at here, this method needs to return the node that has stored this identifier or this key, and answer is the chosen node. Next, we loop on our path. We are sure that our path has at least one element in it, which is the root. So if we are in the first iteration, we are assured that the current node is a leaf node and it should store the data, the key and value. So our first check here is to see if this current node, which is a leaf, as we know, has a space to store this data. So the number of the keys is less than degree minus one. And if it does, it just simply adds the key value and we return from this function. Next, since our current leaf node didn't have any space to store a new value, we create a new leaf node and we create a new list of keys, add the current node keys into that list, add the identifier that we want to add to that list, split it, and pass these new key values to the new sibling leaf. Then fix the pointers, so our current leaf node should point to the new sibling leaf node. And the answer of this method, or the result of this method, should be the node between current leaf node and the newly created leaf node, which now holds the new key. And the reason for that is, if for example here we want to add number 70 to this tree, it should be added to this node, but then this one is full. So we have to create a new node, add 75 and 80 to that one. And we already have this node, 71 should come here. But the result of that function, or the output of that function, should be the current node because it already existed. However, if the new key was 76, then we would have two leaf nodes. This one would be existing. This would be the new one. and 76 would be here, and the answer would be this newly created node. Therefore here the answer would be the node between current node and the new sibling leaf node, which contains the identifier or the new key that we want to add. The next step is to see if our current leaf node doesn't have a parent, and to do that we can check if the path size is 1, and if that's true we need to create a new root, which we do here. And then we set the key of this new root as the first key that we pass to our new leaf node. Then the left pointer should be our current leaf node, and the right one should be the newly created leaf node. All of this happens here. Otherwise, we want our parents to know about this new sibling leaf node that we just created. And the key that the parents should store is the first key that is passed to this new sibling leaf node. The next iterations would be for internal nodes. So the I is not 0, we are not looking for the first node in the path. It's not a leaf anymore. And again, just how we discussed the whole algorithm is recursive before, the current internal node can either add the newly created leaf node as a child and add the key, and in that case we will just return the answer, or the current internal node cannot store the key, so it will split again and the whole logic just repeats. If it is a root itself, then it has to create a new root, pass it to the parent, and then the iteration will happen for the next internal nodes. Now, I realize that the algorithm may be simple, but the code that I have written may look too much. A lot of it is because there are a lot of disk operations here. I have to write the nodes into the disk or into RAM or queue them for later commits. And the other problem that my current code may have right now is that I'm treating the internal nodes and leaf nodes differently. And I haven't figured out how to solve that yet, but the logic of adding new internal node is pretty much like a new leaf node. If you want to see the code for yourself, head on to the repository. The link would be in the description. Go to tree package and then open B+Tree index create operation, and all of the code that you have seen today is available right here. In the next video, we will introduce the structure of nodes, the pointers, and the binary representation of the data that will be stored on the disk. See you in the next video and take care.